Hello everyone and welcome to the short video tutorial series of Planit Pro. I'm Mike Shaw. In this video, let's talk about the user interface of Planit Pro. Do you remember this slide that I used in the introduction video? Planit is mainly about photo planning. We have four required elements in a photo plan: where, what, when, and how. Remembering that the user interface is designed about these four elements will help you understand how Planit works. Where is the camera pin? You can tap the button with a plus sign on the bottom right and set the camera location. This is the camera pin. To place the camera pin at the correct location, we of course need the map. That's why we have the map here. Since the map will be your main working area when you work on a plan, we gave the maximum space to the map in this app. If you want an even bigger space, you can hide the top and the bottom areas by swiping down from the title bar and selecting Hide All. Now you have a full screen. To go back, just swipe down from the title bar again. What is the scene pin and the markers? Again, it requires a map to place the scene pin and to add markers. We'll have separate videos to discuss the camera pin, the scene pin, and the markers, so I'll skip these details for now. When is the date time slider? We put it on the bottom of the user interface, so it is quick to access using your finger. Even if you hold your phone with just one hand, you can still use your thumb to drag the slider like this. We'll have a separate video discussing how to use this area. For now, you just need to remember that whenever you want to change the date or the time, do it in this area. So far, I want to make sure you remember two things. First, to change the location, use the map in the middle. Second, to change the date and time, use the date time area at the bottom. Now let's take a look at the other areas. Starting from the top, we have the title bar right here. The title here shows the plan name you're working on. Plan 1 is the default name. It's like an untitled document if you work with Word. You should tap it to change the name when you decide what plan to work on. You might wonder how you know you can rename the title by tapping here. Well, this little pencil icon here is your key. The pencil icon in Planit means actions such as edit or renaming. It's used consistently across the app, so it's a good idea to remember that. Let's use a new name. How about World Trade Center Moonrise? You can tap this rename button to rename the plan. Or if you want to keep the existing plan, you can also tap the Save As button on the left to save whatever you're working on as a new plan. Then your current plan will still be there. For demo purposes, I'll just tap the Rename button. Here you can see the title says WTC Moonrise. The subtitle shows the location used to calculate all the ephemeris information. It could be the map center or the camera pin. For example, when I haven't yet placed the camera pin, I can drag the map to DC, and now the subtitle says DC. Then, if I drag the map to New York City, the subtitle changes too. It says where the map center currently is. Now, if I place my camera pin in New York City like this and then drag the map to DC, the subtitle still says New York City. That's because the camera pin has priority over the map center. However, sometimes users forget that they left the camera pin somewhere else and drag the map to somewhere like this. To remind them that we use the camera pin to do all the calculations, we'll show a warning message on the top over here. So you know you forgot the camera pin at a distant location whenever you see this message. You can either tap here to release the camera pin, or tap the subtitle to go back to the camera pin. The title bar also can indicate the current selection. For example, I can press and hold the map to select a location, and now the title says Location Selected. The subtitle shows the coordinates of the selected location. You can tap on the subtitle to center the map at this location. Or you can press and hold the title or the subtitle to copy the coordinates. So yes, any coordinates that you can see in this app can be copied by pressing and holding. Then you can send them to your friend using Messenger or share them with another map app. If I tap to select the camera pin, now the title says Camera Selected. The subtitle displays the coordinates as well as the camera height information. The camera does have a height, and by default, we use 1.5 meters or 4.92 feet, which is the same as 1.5 meters. That's the height of the camera on a tripod. The camera height does have a significant impact on your plan. Again, a separate video will show you when you need to set the camera height and how to set it. Whenever you see a back arrow, you can tap it to clear the selection and go back. Over here is the menu button. You can tap it to show more actions. I suggest you go through it to remember what menu items are there. The first section is to purchase and subscribe for more features. The second section has the features of the app. For example, you can register an account with us and log in from here. This is to open the free Planit Live app. The following five menu items are the main functions. You can access all of them on the main user interface. For example, the map button is the same as pressing and holding on this button over here. We include it in the menu so that you can explore and learn it by yourself. The following section is your personal data. Again, we'll have a separate video for each one. The next section has some quick actions. One of them is the settings. Whenever you want to turn on or off a display of something or customize something, go to settings and try to find it there. There's a lot of settings to meet the needs of different people. This last section has less important ones. You can always click them to find out what they are. You won't hurt anything. Now, let's go back to the title bar. On the left, there's a magnifying glass icon. That's the search. You can use it to search for a place name or search for a coordinate. Again, we'll have a separate video for this. The area below the title bar is what we call the ephemeris pager because it has a lot of pages. You can swipe left and right to go to different pages. For adjacent pages, it's okay to swipe, but if I want to just go to a different page quickly, I'll often swipe down from the title bar or pager and then use this dialog to choose the page I want. Okay, so right about now is probably the moment you're starting to feel a little bit overwhelmed. Gosh, how do you have so many pages? Well, each page is a function. We have 22 pages right now, and we do expect to add 5 more pages by the end of this year. So we've divided them up into 5 different categories. The first category has pages all about the sun and the moon. The second category has 5 pages for astrophotographers. The third category has additional special interest pages, and the fourth is meteorology and oceanography. The first 4 categories are part of the Pro feature for just $9.99. The fifth category is the Location Explorer feature, a separate in-app subscription. You can tap on any page to go to that page. It will take you some time to get familiar with those pages. Just remember that they're there. You don't have to use them now. Whenever you need a specific page, you can learn how to use that page at that time. And we'll have a separate video for each page. If you only use some pages, that's totally fine. Don't force yourself to use all of them. In addition to this short video series, we'll also have a Learn by Example series. I'll jump around these pages in those videos to do different things as part of the plan. By watching those videos, you'll see why we have so many pages and how powerful they are by working together in combination. You can also see some colored rectangles below the pager. It indicates what page you're on. You can tap on them to jump to any given page. For example, I know the green rectangles are the special interest category. The first one is the time-lapse page. So I can tap the first green rectangle and it jumps straight to the time-lapse page. Of course, you'll need some time to remember the page order, but once you become familiar with the app, you'll find these little rectangles to be a real time saver. Don't worry if you're on Android and don't see the colored rectangles. It's a setting that you can change. Go to Menu, Settings, General, check or uncheck tabs for the ephemeris pages, and you'll see 2 different interfaces. If I check it, go back. You'll see the tabs on the top of the pager. You can scroll and tap to select a page. Instead of just color rectangles with no name, now you see the name of each page. It's easier for beginners to use this interface, but more advanced users probably prefer the other interface since it takes less screen space. This user interface option is only available on the Android. Many Android phones have a sizable height-to-width ratio, so it's okay for the tabs here to take some extra vertical space. The height-to-width ratio for the iPhone is smaller, so we didn't add this option. Next, we come to the map again. On the top left, we have the Map Layer button. Tap it to allow yourself to select the map layer, such as a normal map, satellite map, and so forth. Pressing and holding will allow you to choose a different map provider, such as Mapbox or a few other maps that are mainly useful in China. On the top right, you'll find the Current Location button. Tap it to center the map at your current location. Below the Current Location button is a multi-purpose zoom slider. In addition to the default map zoom function, it also has several other helpful functions that can help improve your productivity. We'll show you a few of these in the video for the camera pin and the scene pin. On the bottom right, we have two big round buttons. They're large because you'll use them more than the other buttons. The action button, or as I call it, the plus button, contains actions related to a plan, including set the camera pin, the scene pin, add a marker, list local markers, and shared markers. And over here, it has actions such as undo, redo, create a new plan, list the task, save a new task, add a reminder, and so forth. The viewfinder button has buttons to access the four viewfinders, VR, AR, Picture VR, and Google Street View. And over here are six photography tools. They are the coordinate and elevation tool, the distance and view tool, the focal length tool, the depth of field tool, the panorama tool, and the aerial photography tool. There are also other ways to choose the six tools. You can do it by swiping down from this tool info area, or you can go to Menu, Photography Tools. All three are exactly the same. Use them in whatever way you feel the most comfortable. I use the swipe down way most of the time. Again, we'll have different videos to talk about these six tools. To summarize, there are tons of information and functions in this app, but the logic is clear. All the functions are built in to make it possible to create a photo plan. Everything you can do with a real camera, you can do in Planit with its virtual camera. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching and enjoy learning and using Planit.